Hi, this is Jose Luis, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to, from what we've done in the previous videos, which was creating a C# WebSocket client that could read JSON information of the location of this moving ball in a P5's canvas, both of them connected via a WebSocket server. What I'm going to do is I'm going to have some fun with this, and I'm going to take the X and Y location that I'm reading coordinated from this animation. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just draw some ASCII rectangle on my console terminal so that I can draw kind of a circle on this canvas and coordinate the geometry of the P5 sketch with the C# ASCII art, whatever. And for that, I'm going to base myself on some of the code that I already wrote for in the C# learning C# playlist. The one where we were doing ASCII art from the command line, and if you remember, we were able to generate, for example, we were able to generate custom rectangles with custom width and custom height. So I'm going to, if you want to learn more about how I did that, please consider going to this video on the Learning C# playlist. Okay, so what I'm going to do is from that video, I'm going to copy paste the function that I use to draw an empty rectangle. And it was a function that I could give it a width and a height and a border, and then it would draw a rectangle with this. And just for the sake of, I'm actually just going to draw a rectangle. So draw empty rectangle, and that's going to be with 50 characters and 15 characters and one character border. And if I run this, you can see that it just draws this rectangle, and then it does the whole WebSocket stuff. Okay, so what I would like to do is use this code to now position the ball and draw a new rectangle whenever I get coordinates for the position of the ball. So it's going to be actually super, super easy. I'm going to remove this. Okay, and then I'm going to modify this function a little bit. So I'm going to call it draw dot, and then I'm going to add a couple more parameters, which are going to be double is going to be the X position normalized. Now another one is going to be double the Y position. I'm not going to do the normalized, it's going to be normalized, but the X position, the Y position, and I'm going to maintain the width and the height options. Now, what I would like to do is, first of all, remember that what I'm getting from the server is coordinates in normalized space. That means a value from 0 to 1. So what I need to do here before I do anything, I need to calculate in which character. So if the width of the rectangle, for example, is 50, what I need to figure out is for position 0.32, blah, 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 how far along in the 50 pixels this circle is going to be. So I'm going to need to convert from normalize coordinates to character coordinates or pixel, whatever you want to pixel coordinates. All right, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create X is going to be equal to, I'm going to round up multiplying the normalized position by the width. Okay, and you're going to see that this gives me an error because round, the function, returns a double, which I find a little weird. I don't even know why this is the case, but this is just as easy as casting the result of this function, the outcome, and casting it into an integer. And then I can create another integer called y equals an integer of math round the y position times the height, where we are in the height space. And so I think that's going to be it. And then something that we can do here is we can modify the conditions about what character gets drawn when. So if you remember here, I have this condition to draw the border. I have another condition to draw an empty and dot. So I'm actually going to replace this with a white space. And what I would do now is I would add another condition that checks if J and Y are actually on the X and Y location where the circle should be, and then draw like a big O or like a zero. So I'm going to do that, the first one, because I want that one to be the one with the most priority. So if I equals equals x, the x position, and at the same time, if j equals equals the y location that we just calculated, then console, oops, console write the character, for example, capital O. Otherwise, I'm going to replace that. Otherwise, if blah, 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 if it's a border, then draw the asterisk. Otherwise, draw a white space. Okay. And then once we have this function, then it's just as simple as I'm going to comment this out. And then I'm going to use the values that I have serialized into a vector to call that draw dot function. So I'm going to say, once I receive a message from the server, I want to draw a dot, and I'm going to draw it at position X. I'm going to draw it at position Y, and then the width and the height are going to be whatever. So for example, 50 and 15 and 1 pixel border. It's not really pixels, it's characters, but you get the point. So I'm going to run this. Aren't you excited about this? Aren't you excited? Wait, let me zoom in. All right. And then let me open the other B5 editor. I'm going to refresh this just in case. And ta-na-na-na, it's happening. Boom. And now, boom. And you see the ball, boom, all the way down here and all the way at the top corner and all the way here, yoo-hoo, and here at the center, yoo-hoo. Ooh. How cool is this, really? All right. So, pew, 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 pew. Oops. Oh, something went wrong. Unable to read data from the transport connection. Oh, the connection went wrong. Something broke. Okay, we broke it. We were having too much fun, apparently. So let me just do this again. So I'm going to connect here and I'm going to reconnect this guy. And yes, so we get, okay. All right. So this looks cool to me. Okay. I can't help this. So let me, all right. Okay. Let's stop goofing a little bit. Okay, wonderful. So that was coordinating geometry between a... Oops, somebody is doing this from the live stream. Somebody's controlling this right now from the live stream that I'm recording this tutorial at, which is being recorded live, for those of you who may not know. Okay, wonderful. So this is great. So we have this working, and we have been able to create geometry both in a P5 sketch, on a front end, living on the cloud, and with an ASCII kind of art with a C# console application, connecting them both with the WebSocket server that we implemented in the previous videos on this playlist, Fun with WebSockets. So if you like what you saw, consider subscribing and liking this video and all those things. And I think what I'm going to do in the next video is, just for the sake of completeness, I may want to teach you how to now actually write a WebSocket server using a C# console application, okay? Which might be useful for many other things, such as creating a small local network of things connected on your machine, or writing it in Unity and then connecting other services to your server, etc., etc. There's a lot of applications that you could use here, okay? All right, wonderful. So see you on the next video. Thank you.